Welcome to the lesson, UVM Drivers and Sequencers. After completion of this lesson, you'll be able to describe how to declare and construct a UVM sequencer, describe the structure of a UVM driver, identify the name of the TLM connection in UVM driver, and explain why a TLM port and export are connected in the connect phase. How do UVM sequencers and drivers work together? The sequencer, which is part of an agent, is sent transactions by a sequence and then sends them to the driver in this agent. Most of the time, a sequencer is fed by a single sequence. You can have a single sequencer fed by multiple sequences. This sequencer has to arbitrate between them, as shown in a later lesson. The UVM sequencer class does its job so well that it's almost never extended. The class is parameterized and so needs to be specialized with the sequence item type. Here are two ways to declare a sequencer and an agent. The fast way is shown in the TX agent class on the left, where a handle SQR is declared as type UVM sequencer that is specialized to carry TX item objects. The other way to declare a sequencer handle is by creating a new type, TX sequencer, shown in green, then use that type to declare the SQR handle in TX agent. This style is helpful if you need to declare TX sequencer handles in multiple places. Plus, the SQR handle declaration looks like the driver handle declaration. The preferred style is on the left, as it is short and does not require creating another type. The driver receives sequence items from the sequencer and calls methods in the interface to send them along to the DUT. Optionally, a driver can get the response from the DUT and send it back to the sequence. The sequencer and driver communicate with a special version of a TLM blocking connection. The connection is bidirectional, so the sequence is able to send a request to the driver, and the driver optionally sends a response back. In this course, it's drawn with a unidirectional arrow for simplicity. Where does the driver come from? The base class is UVM driver, which is parameterized. The first type is REQ for the request type, and the second is RSP for the response type, with the default of the request type. Here's the declaration for the special TLM connection, seek item port, which is bidirectional. It's constructed in the base class, so you don't have to. The TX driver class extends UVM driver and specializes it with the TX item type. Since there's just one type, the response type defaults to TX item. Since TX driver is a component, you need to register it with the UVM factory. Notice the macro is UVM component utils. The constructor has two formal arguments, the instance name and a handle to the parent. You do not need default values for these, unlike a sequence item. These four lines are similar for most components, so future code examples will just leave them out. Here is more code for a driver, which pulls transactions from the sequence and sends them to the DUT. The driver needs a handle VIF to the interface so it can send the transaction. You'll learn in a later lesson how the handle is stored in a database and retrieved here. The real work of a driver is performed in the run phase. First, declare a handle to a transaction. Second, the driver gets the next transaction from the sequence by calling getNextItem. This is the TLM port that you saw declared in the UVM driver base class. Third, the driver calls a method in the interface, such as transfer, to send the transaction to the DUT. When that task returns, the driver tells the sequence it's done with the transaction by calling itemDone. Optionally, it can send a response, not shown here. The driver and sequencer are UVM components, part of the agent. An agent has a driver and has a sequencer. The TX agent class has handles for the driver and sequencer. During the build phase, components create lower level components. Here, the driver is created and the sequencer is constructed. Since the UVM sequencer class is almost never extended, don't bother calling the factory to create it. Save yourself the overhead, even if just a small amount. The TLM port in the driver is called sequence item port. The sequencer's export is called sequence item export. This TLM connection is a special version of the UVM blocking port that can handle bidirectional transfers. In the connect phase, connect the initiator, the driver, to the target, which is the sequencer. Why can't you do this during the build phase? Components are built from the top down, so when the agent's build phase is running, the driver and sequencer have not run their build phase method and are not ready to connect. You need to wait until the next phase, connect. You will learn more about the agent class in upcoming lessons. In summary, in this lesson you learned how to declare and construct a UVM sequencer, declare the structure of a UVM driver, identify the name of the TLM connection in UVM driver, and explain why a TLM port and export are connected in the connect phase. This concludes the lesson, UVM Drivers and Sequencers.